Thanks for having me. As I said before, I will today talk about an overview of .NET desktop application development. I think most of us are here for mobile, but I think desktop is also really important. Before I go to the content, I will just quickly introduce myself. So my name is Konrad Müller. I work for Zülke and do mobile and software development there. Additionally, I do a lot of .NET development in general, backend, front end, whatever, also cloud stuff. Everything that's there. If you have any questions or want to contact me and network a bit afterwards, you can feel free to tweet out to me on Twitter or on GitHub. I'm there, so just reach out. Yeah. So before we talk about technologies and samples, I just want to first clarify a little question, which I think is really important, and that's why should we do this? Why should we even develop apps for desktop and not just create more and more mobile apps? And I think there's a really compelling reason for that. As you know, that devices are getting bigger and bigger. So we started with tiny little iPhones, and now we are having big iPad Pros and laptop-like iPads, and even laptops are getting more popular. Additionally, we see more and more iPads and MacBooks in the enterprise world. So I think it really makes sense today to create desktop applications for the better ergonomics that you have, for better inputs with the keyboard and the mouse. You have a bigger screen. Of course, you also have performance. So if you have some application which needs performance, satisfied by a browser performance or a mobile performance, and you need a desktop application, you have full access to your platform API. With a mobile app, you're always in a sandbox, which is of course a good thing, but can also limit you a bit. And as I said, of course, there are now also iPad OS and MacBooks getting rolled out more and more. Even at Microsoft now, people are using MacBooks. So I think it really makes sense to develop apps for these platforms. So what to expect from a desktop framework? First of all, we definitely want to support our platforms. So we want to support Windows, macOS, iPadOS, and even Linux, if that's possible. We want to develop with one language. We are coming all from Xamarin, so we are having a .NET, C#, F# background. So just using one language would be really good to share business logic, to share view logic. Our UI should be shared, so we want to create one UI and which can be run on all platforms, or even create dedicated UIs for each platform, but have one unified business logic code base. And we want to have platform access, so we want to have access to the API, if possible, in a native way, so that we can do everything in one language in C# and not have to use like plugins or something, so that we can really do everything which a native developer could do on the platform as well. Okay. Now, of course, people went to Microsoft and say, please, Microsoft, give us a framework for that. Give us a .NET cross-platform UI framework. And for many years, there was nothing like that. Then .NET Core came. And before that, also Mono. But with .NET Core, we could create cross-platform code with C# and F# and just the whole .NET stack, which ran across all platforms, even on ARM nowadays. But there was never a native UI framework which was part of .NET Core. Even Xamarin was really not part of the .NET Core or .NET 5.6 stack. Of course, we had WPF and WinForms already, which were the, I think, most popular .NET desktop frameworks. And they could also run on .NET Core, which made running them across multiple Windows platforms way easier. But you can't run them on macOS, for example, or Linux. So they were always limited to Windows. Of course, Xamarin was an option. So Xamarin is now also part of Microsoft since 2016. And with Xamarin, we get access to iOS, Android, and macOS, and also GTK with GTK Sharp, I think it's called, through Mono. So we can now access all the platforms, and we can write a UI in the platform code. So we can use the AppKit development tools and so on. We can use all the native ways to create UI, but also with Xamarin Forms, create one UI which is then shared across all platforms. I don't have to explain Xamarin here, but that's what we got until now. My issue with Xamarin Forms was always that it's, in my opinion, primarily focused on mobile. I think you could always see that the primary development focus of Microsoft went into mobile and into iOS and Android, and desktop platforms were always a bit behind. I think UWP for Windows was always good, well supported, but when we look at macOS and WPF, it was always an okay experience. So I personally would have not built a whole enterprise app for desktop with summary forms. That's my opinion. But now we are in the future, and now we have .NET 6 and .NET MAUI. At least we will have soon. So .NET 6 will release soon, and .NET MAUI will release hopefully somewhere next year. And they give us all the options that we need to create great desktop applications. So before we dive into .NET MAUI, we first have to dive into the two new platform technologies for macOS and for Windows. And I want to start with macOS. Because there we, of course, have our old summary macOS, so a port or bindings for AppKit, which powers macOS development. That's similar to UIKit for iOS development. So that was what you could use before. And now you also have a new option, which I think is really nice, because the issue was always that AppKit is a bit different than UIKit. So when you could create iOS apps with C#, you still had to learn something to create macOS apps with C#, because it was a slight difference in API and in UI. But now with MacCatalyst, Apple brings a technology which allows you to simply run iOS apps on macOS and also access AppKit APIs. And therefore, we only have to run one code base and only have to know one language, so the UIKit language in C#, and can bring that to macOS and iOS. And of course, that makes it way easier to create frameworks like .NET MAUI, because now you only have to implement the iOS part and the UIKit part, and then just bring this to macOS and have way less effort in maintaining all of that. The great thing is that today, all of that is creatable in the console. So if you have the .NET CLI installed, have the .NET MAUI workloads installed, you can just create a new .NET Mac app or a MacCatalyst app. It's really easy, and it's also what will power .NET MAUI. Additionally, for Windows, there's also something really interesting happening in the last years. You might have heard of Project Reunion and what's now known as a Windows App SDK. So the Windows App SDK is an effort by Microsoft to unify all the API access, all the there's a whole development on Windows and ship it as one SDK, which is usable from your known languages, like, for example, C#, C++, Visual.net, and also something like JavaScript with React Native. And part of this Windows App SDK, which contains a lot of APIs, is also WinUI 3 or WinUI in general. And WinUI 3 is a decoupling of all the XAML controls and all the XAML runtimes and so on that and inputs that you know from UWP. And that gets now decoupled from Windows, so you don't have to publish it through a Windows update, but you can just add it to your app using a .NET Nugget package. So that makes it, of course, easier to be compatible with different Windows versions and so on. And you also get access to latest patterns and latest functions from Microsoft, like, for example, the Fluent design pattern, which is heavily promoted in WinUI, is now all accessible. As I said, WinUI is a UI framework layer, and it can sit on top of Win32 apps, so WPF and WinForms, or on universal platform Windows platform apps, so UWP. And of course, if you want to only run on Windows and want to have really deep API access and all the Win32 access APIs, then you can just use a WPF app, for example, and run on Windows. But if you use UWP as the underlying layer, which also offers you stuff like sandboxing and all the UWP packaging goodness, then you can also distribute your app to Xbox or HoloLens or Surface Hub, and of course also Windows. So that's also quite new things. So if you want to create desktop applications just for .NET, just for Windows, then WinUI is the way to go. It's currently in version 0.8, and I think not part of the default Visual Studio installing experience, but it's an extension which you can just install, and then you get templates and so on. So it's, I think, a really, really nice effort from Microsoft there. Okay. drink a sip. And then we come to Dutton Maui finally. So what we saw before were all efforts to create applications for a certain platform, but with Dutton Maui we can now of course unify all of this into one framework, into one application, which can then run across many platforms. So as you know, I don't have to explain what Dutton Maui is. Dutton Maui is a successor or the evolution to Xamarin Forms, and it uses WinUI 3 and MacCatalyst to power Windows and Mac. And as I said before, WinUI 3 is just a really nice new framework, which brings benefits of the UWP world to our new world, and MacCatalyst just makes it easier to maintain all of that, because the .MAUI team just has to maintain one iOS platform or one UI kit platform. Of course, with .MAUI, you have shared UI with XAML and C#, but you could, of course, also just create a new project, create a shared project, and then just create a dedicated WinUI project and a dedicated Mac project, and just share your business logic and create the UI in the different projects. So that would also be possible. That would not be .NET MAUI, but just another way. .NET MAUI is also part of the .NET CLI now. You just need the workload, and we will now dive into that just as a little demo, just to show you how that looks like currently. So I'm here on my Mac, and I have a VM open at the same time. Okay, just checking that everything works. Okay. All right. So, yeah, as I said, this is my VM, and I open my MAUI sample now. And what we can see is that we have our platforms as we know it, and part of these platforms is of course Windows. That was before always a different project, but now it's all part of one project which contains all platforms, which I think is really nice. And when we open this, we can see that we have a manifest and a package information like we know it from UWP, but we also have an app XAML and an app XAML code behind. And here we can see that it's a WinUI project and it's using a WinUI application wrapped in MAUI. We can also see this when we go into the project file, that we're using the Microsoft Windows App SDK with WinUI, and that we are using .NET 6 somewhere here, yeah. .NET 6 for Windows. And if you look at the same thing on Mac, so this is now on Mac, this is Visual Studio for Mac preview. If you go in here and look at it doesn't load, okay. Let's close this and do the same thing on Windows. So if we do it on Windows, it's the same project, so it's the same code. If we go in here and open our app delegate, first of all, we can now see that our app delegate is a UI application delegate, so it's a UI kit. It's the same that we have in the iOS project. So this is really, really, really similar. We can have the broken CS and the info plist, so it's really the same, just shipped to macOS later on. And when we go to the project, we can see at the top here that we have MacCatalyst as the target together with iOS. I had to remove Android here for performance reasons. So you really have .NET 6 shipping all of that out of the box or with the additional workloads. Okay, I will just run this now really quick just to see that it actually works and to provoke the demo gods. Yeah, you can distribute MacCatalyst apps outside of the App Store, but nowadays Apple added some signing stuff to Mac apps as well. So you have to instruct your users how to do it, and you have to sign it a bit, and then they have to agree to launch it. So it's, I think, not as much of a nice option as just using the Apple App Store for that. So that's my .NET MAUI sample running on Windows here. I can just click and increase it. That's just the default demo. I'm not about code here. I'm just about platforms. So yeah, it works, as you can see. I hope you know that I'm not lying, and it really is an experience. I'm really happy about this. I'm really happy that desktop is supported by .NET MAUI, and I really hope that they are committed to this and that they will support it properly. Because I can really see myself creating desktop apps with .NET MAUI, and I hope that's a great experience in the future. Okay, There are also third-party options for that. I will show you two today. One is Avalonia UI. Avalonia UI is a community project. It's also using XAML and C#. It's also, in that case, really similar to all our known .NET UI frameworks. So it looks really similar. The interesting part about Avalonia UI is that it's that it draws its UI with C#. So it doesn't use like .NET MAUI and Xamarin native controls to create the UI, but has a UI which is drawn with Skia, similar to what Javier showed before. And it's also independent, so it's just community driven. There's, I think, no big company behind it, but I think it's also really charming. Has, of course, also its downsides. It supports Windows and macOS as deployment targets, and mobile support is coming, but at the moment it's perfect for desktop development. I don't have a sample here, but there is a really great control gallery sample in the apps in the Microsoft Store. We can click a bit around and see all the layouts, and as you can see, it's looking really good. Has all the inputs that we need. So I think this is a really great option if you want to try it, and if you are into custom drawings. The next thing here that I want to show you is Uno. You probably heard of Uno platform now, and Uno platform is a different approach from, I think, Inventive. What they do is essentially take a WinUI and formerly UWP app, implement the whole API surface in a cross-platform way, and then you can basically run your WinUI code across all platforms. So this is really nice if you're coming from a WinUI UWP background, have your existing code base maybe, and just want to port it to macOS and Linux, for example, then you can just take Uno and it will most likely run across all platforms. Uno also runs on XAML and C#, as WinUI does, and it really runs across all platforms. So Android iOS is also supported, Tizen, and also WebAssembly, so you can run it as a website. I think that's really exciting. You have full API access since it's using Xamarin as its platform layer for macOS and iOS and Android, and it's using native controls, but they are styled like UWP controls or WinUI controls. So it's again one code base, one UI base with similar look across all platforms. Let's take a look at Uno, just to make this a bit clearer. Sample. So again, I'm on my Windows box here, and this is the Uno sample. As you can see, you have different platforms. So mobile is what I uploaded here for performance reasons again, but Linux, WPF also, and UWP, which is, I think, mostly WinUI now, and also WebAssembly, so the website part. And if I select this as a launch platform now, I can launch this, but first let's look at the shared code. So this is the shared code where you actually implement your code and your UI. Looks really similar to WPF, to Xamarin Forms, to .NET MAUI. It's always the same stuff, I think, at least from a programming standpoint. Here you have a main page, and the great thing is that since this is so similar to WinUI and it's using the same things, you have features like, normally you have features like the editor, for example, that you can just use editor to create your UI. You can use the toolbox, for example. So everything, all of the great Visual Studio support for WinUI for UWP works with Uno. I think that makes it really, really great. Let's launch this as well. This will be a bit of a simpler sample because we just have a slider and a text box. But just to show you how that it works and how it works. I hope it works. Unfortunately, I don't have a demo of Avalonia available today. I would also be a bit tight on the time schedule. So this is the Uno sample. It's really really simple, but as you can see, it's a nice looking UI, just with the WinUI style. And the interesting part, let's see if I can launch this at the same time, is that you can launch the same thing also in the browser. So if you say, okay, I don't want to ship a whole MSI file with an installer attached, or I want to distribute it through the App Store, I can run the same thing. Can I do this? Should be possible. I can run the same thing just as a website, just serve it. And then I can also deliver it on that way. I will get a bit more into detail into WebAssembly later. Just want to show this now. Yeah. So this will, of course, compile it and also run up a little Kestrel server on my PC now to host the files. I think later on you can just use a file server, basically. Okay. So if we now load this page, it will load all the files. And if I had told this side by side now, you can see that this is a native GWP desktop app, and this is a website app, and it's really similar. So just that this is native control and this is HTML. So I think it's really great to have this flexibility. Okay, let's close this all again. Otherwise, I think my PC will just burn. Okay, and continue, because time is always a limited resource. Okay, so now we looked at the traditional just create an app with your frameworks and then just distribute it as a package. So that's what we knew before. That was already available until now. But there are new things which I'm really excited about, which we can use in the future. And one of the things that we have to know for that is WebAssembly, which is also something which is rather new. And WebAssembly is a technology or a standard which is basically deploying assembly or WebAssembly files to the web. So it's an alternative to the JavaScript engine in modern browsers, just that you can then run WebAssembly code or WebAssembly binaries. And that has some benefits. For example, it's really fast, it's really performative. It's supported by all browsers, vendors by now, I think, also on mobile and desktop. So there's no issue in like distribution options. And the great thing is that you can compile .NET or the .NET runtime into WebAssembly and then ship .NET in your browser. And I think that's a really great thing that you know, can now basically create C# code that runs natively in the browser. You don't have like transcompile code from C# to JavaScript. You don't have to like do any server-side rendering. You can just create code that runs natively in the browser, which I think opens up many possibilities. And the one you should probably have heard by now is Blazor. So Blazor is, I think, one of the latest .NET client-side frameworks which you can use to run client-side code in the browser. This makes then use of WebAssembly to run the code in the end. And it looks a lot of, so if you look at the code, it looks really like a Razor project, just that the code won't be executed on the server side and then be pre-rendered, but it will just run on the client. It's also available through the CLI, but let's look at it in person and then explore a bit how this looks like. I will do this on my Mac now in Visual Studio Code. I have it open at the moment. Yeah. So this is my Blazor project, by the way. This is a whole sample project which contains all the samples and which I will upload afterwards. So if you go into Blazor PVA or into this Blazor file, we can see, okay, we have a program.cs, it's a CS project, it's a really a normal .NET project, but we have pages which are written in HTML and in this Razor syntax, and then we can just use inline C# code, and it will all get pushed to the client later on and then executed there. So I think that's really interesting that you can now finally create really natively running C# code and don't need stuff like Silverlight for that or something. So I'm really happy about it. If you run this, I'm always a bit amazed that we can actually see DLL files loaded by the browser. So let's do that here. And look at the sample. I will open the HTTP. Oh, as a screen. So yeah, so this is a sample. And if I go to my network, first I have to clear my website data. Okay. And if I now go to my network tab and then reload this page, we can really see all the DLL files getting loaded in. They get cached afterwards, so that's why I had to clear all the data. But it's really interesting that we have a native .NET experience in the browser on the client, which I think is really, really new and really great. Yeah, as I said, the next time it's loaded, it will only load the necessary files and not all of the DLLs. But yeah, I think this is a really nice approach to do development. Again, since this is .NET, we will do a counter. So yeah, it works. And I think websites are a great way that when you can't distribute your application as a real desktop application, as a native application, just use a website. It's really similar in terms of ergonomics and inputs, and also has API access. You can access all the APIs, which the browser will ask you to. Oh, this was the wrong tab. So we'll have access to many APIs, like for example, microphone and camera, or also file access and so on. So you really have many options, just not all options, to access the whole platform natively with all the hidden APIs and so on. So a website might be a good option. And with Blazor, you have a great option in C Sharp. Okay. Now, if I go back to my presentation, there's one more thing which I think is also really exciting about the whole Blazor and website stuff, and that's that you can create progressive web apps from it. So a progressive web app, or a PWA, is basically an installable website. So you can add some magic files to your website, to any website, really. It doesn't have to be Angular or Blazor or anything of that. You just add some manifest files to define how your app should look like on the desktop later on. And then you can add stuff like offline capabilities. Again, of course, access all the browser APIs. And then you will get an option to install the app as an application on your desktop. And that makes this whole website experience a bit more native. Great examples for PWAs are, for example, Twitter and the Outlook app, which you can just install from the browser into your desktop environment and then have a really nice experience, which you can just launch from your application drawer. And Uno and Blazor support this, of course, since they're also websites, and they also support this with CLI commands. So you can just create a new Blazor WebAssembly application with PWA support out of the box really easily. You might have noticed that my project is already called Blazor PWA. So this already contains all the files. It was created with this command I just showed. And what we have now is, for example, this manifest file, which defines our icon later on and our colors, for example. And we have a service worker. And the service worker is a new feature, is a new web feature, which lets us cache files, which gives us this offline capability, and also allows for push messages to be retrieved. So you can really have a really nice and near native experience with your website. So if we go back to our sample here, we can see at the top right that you have this little plus symbol here that says that I can install this app as a website, this website as an app. So if I say, okay, install, it will install it and also straight away open it again. So this is now my application standalone. I can launch it from my app drawer. So if I say Blazor PWA, launch it. It's really a native look and feel. But in this case, I really can have it, and I think most normal users won't even notice that it's a website, have it as a desktop experience. Yeah, you can also debug it and go into it, so it's really still a web experience, and it's running in the engine, in the browser engine which is used to install it. But yeah, I think it's a really nice option, or a really nice middle way between desktop app and website. Okay. But there's more. So of course, we don't have full access to the API now. It's unlimited at this point. And we can't ship this PWA as a native application, and we can't like have it as an installer available on the website. So something really popular which we can do now is using Electron. And Electron is a JavaScript or TypeScript framework, which you can use to wrap your websites into a container. And then this container can be shipped as a desktop application. And then you have your app available as a desktop app. Electron is really popular. Many great apps are built using Electron. And since Electron is then running natively, it can also add a bridge from the website to your native API, and you can then access all the APIs and not just the browser APIs. So the browser rendering engine is only used to render your HTML and run the JavaScript code in the website, but you can really add all native code to your Electron app and really access everything through plugins. So that's, I think, a really nice way to bring your JavaScript apps to the native desktop world. Now, of course, Electron is a bit loved and hated. You have the issue of burning PCs, of freezing PCs, because browser engines like to eat up all your RAM and all your CPU power. And when you create everything in Electron, you get to the point where you have a bit of an issue. I think this is a bit of an overstatement. I think Electron apps are really great and have a really big benefit. But just I think this is a common joke about that. So it would be great to do the same with our Blazor site, right? It would be great that we can then now create a website with Blazor, with HTML, which offers many great UI ways to implement stuff. Maybe it's a bit more flexible compared to XAML and C Sharp. And the great thing is that we can do it now. We can basically wrap our Blazor apps as a native app. Interestingly enough, I was doing this same talk or a similar talk 1.5 years ago. And at this point, all of what I will show you now was just like experimental and really in early preview or just available as like private dev blogs of Microsoft devs. So it was all just an idea. And now it's really great to see this all coming to life and really be usable in the future. And one of the things and what I'm most excited about is Blazor Desktop or basically the Blazor WebView. And the Blazor WebView is a new control which is available for WPF and WinForms and UI, but also for .NET MAUI. So what Blazor WebView does is basically add the option to wrap your Blazor app inside of your desktop application. And that offers many great possibilities. For example, first of all, of course, we can just distribute our Blazor website as a desktop application. And just wrap it, ship it, also add a bridge to native APIs, so we can then access the whole API surface of the platform, so we have no limits anymore, it's all available. And the great thing as well is that we can mix and match native elements. We can, for example, take an existing legacy WPF application with our legacy and existing UI controls, and if you want to have, for example, a new site which we want to create with new and modern HTML elements, we can then just add a Blazor site for this one page or this one control, and then mix it together and have one unified experience, but can use modern tools and also maybe migrate to a full Blazor or to a full HTML experience in the future. Additionally, Blazor WebView is using the .NET runtime directly, which is shipped with your application. So if, for example, you ship your WPF app with .NET 6, the Blazor website will also use this runtime and not like a WebAssembly runtime. So it's also really fast. It doesn't add too much weight to your application. It's also available from your .NET CLI. Today we will look at the MAUI, at the .NET MAUI way to do this. So we can just run this with the .NET new MAUI Blazor command. And what you will get then is something like this. So this is a MAUI Blazor application. And if you look at it, it looks basically like you would wrap together, if you would merge together a MAUI application and a Blazor application. So it's just both of them combined together. And that's basically what it is. So we have our root file, we have our pages here with our Razor pages. So this is our Razor stuff. And then that's the magic. We have a main page, and there we have this Blazor WebView control. And this references our index page of the Blazor site. And then we have inside of our content page grid a Blazor WebView, which we can just run and have available. And the great thing is that this also has access to our whole site. So I, for example, have in my startup code. Yeah, where is it? Oh no, in my app code, sorry. I have an app state defined. So this is my app state, which I now have. Which has a counter, which I can increment and then fires an event to change the value in the view. And I can access this counter from my Blazor counter page. So I can really mix and match all the code together, have access to the whole context. So if I run this now, so this is now a .NET MAUI application, but inside is a Blazor page. I have my counter, and my counter is using my apps that which I just showed. So we really have an Electron-like experience just with .NET MAUI, and I think this is really interesting and opens up many possibilities. I think it's even a bit funny. And yes, you can also like debug it with your dev tools. So you can have your dev tools in your .NET MAUI application, then inspect your elements. So I think this is really great. And I think it really makes sense to use HTML as your UI layer, since it's so powerful and maybe more powerful and flexible compared to XAML. So this is a really great way. But as I said, more interestingly, you can also mix this. So if I go back here, and what I will do now is basically take the code from my MAUI sample and just put it in here together with my web page. So I have here my web view. And now I will just take my code from my MAUI example. Where's my mouse there? This is the MAUI example with this little debug bot who's waving at us and with the counter. And additionally, I have a grid with two columns. And and both of these controls are now part of one application, are shared, and additionally, this button, which will increase the click amount, will also have to add the back, the code behind code. Oop. So that's the code behind. This is similar code behind code to the demo from .NET MAUI. So this will also access the app state. So both my Blazor app through Razor and my .NET MAUI app through the normal code behind code will now access my app state and will both increase the counter. So I really have unified experience here. And of course, you can do stuff like MVVM and so on and create services which are shared, and then you can call the services and have a really nice app state or something like a reactive pattern or something. But the point is you can share all of it and you are really in one unified solution. And when I run this now, I will launch my Visual Studio on Mac at the same time. So if I run this now, I now have my .NET desktop application wrapped in GWP running with .NET MAUI and having on the left side my .NET MAUI controls, which of course use native controls in the end. And on the right side, I have my Blazor page, which is using HTML. And if I go on both pages to my counter now and increase it on one page, then it will also increase on the other page, so you can really share data and also, for example, access APIs from the Blazor page now. And I think that's really interesting and opens many possibilities. I repeat myself, but I'm really happy about that, about this option now. And I think it will help bring many legacy apps to the future. So I think, really great that this is now coming and will be part of .NET 6 or .NET MAUI. I don't know exactly when it will be released or when it's finished, or if it's finished. Information are a bit rare, but just to see this is really good. Okay, we can do the same thing, by the way, on Mac if it works now. Yeah. So with the Studio Preview for Mac, let's open this up. I have a bit of time left, so that's good. Yeah, so this is the same code, just on my Mac now, and not in the VM. And here again, we have the Blazor web view and our normal view and the code behind that I showed you before. And if I launch this now, and it doesn't complain too much, something's red. Yeah, and that's the same thing, just this time in a Mac Catalyst application, basically. So the same thing, just on Mac, and it works. So really, now there are many options to create .NET desktop applications with .NET MAUI or other options. So I think that's really great. I saw one question in the chat asking if I can use MAUI to replace a web view in production and without other features of MAUI. So first of all, of course, you can use better web view without MAUI, just using it in a WPF project, for example, or in a Mercatalyst project, for example, or in a WinForms project. That's possible, so you don't need MAUI with it together. But I think it's not released yet for as stable release. I think it's just part of .NET 6, which is currently in preview. And I'm not sure if it will be part of .NET 6 or if it will be part of .NET MAUI, so it will be released later this year. Not too much information on me here, but there will be a talk later by David Ortono from Microsoft, who will maybe discuss this a bit more and can answer that. So maybe ask again there, because he should know. Okay. Now we discussed many options, and I think, please don't build again. Thank you. So many options that we have. I think many new options, many exciting options, but maybe a bit too much. So as a last thing, I want to give you a bit of a decision helper, because there are so many things that you can do, and the question is, what should I do now? So if you are a C# developer and you want to build a desktop application, or you have a team of C# developers and want to create a desktop application, what should you use? The first question would be, what's your platform? So if you want to develop only for macOS, just use .NET macOS or .NET macOS Catalyst, for example. That's a really nice way. Just use your full API access, full native control. So that's, I think one great way. The same goes for Windows. If you want to create a Windows app, just use WinUI 3. Best way to go here. Of course, if you want to go multi-platform or cross-platform, then the question is, which UI technology do you want to use? One option, of course, is HTML, which I think, as I said before, is really great and powerful language with many great frameworks for it. So then the question is just, do I want to access my platform API natively, or is it enough to just use browser features, for example, like file access, camera access, audio access, GPS access? If that's enough, I can just go with Blazor PWA, and I have a really nice website with a really nice native experience. And if I really want to have full native access, I can go with Blazor, with MAUI Blazor, or just a Blazor web view. That's also great, I think. And if you want to go with XAML and C# and your known .NET experience, basically, you can either create a shared UI, so create one UI implementation, which is used across multiple platforms, and then you can go with .NET MAUI, UNO, or Avalonia, or you could say, okay, I want to create dedicated UIs for all platforms, but just want to share my business logic, and then you can go for multiple implementations and implement one UI for macOS, one for WinUI, and just share your business code. And I think that's so a bit of the decision chart which I would choose if I had to say that. Of course, it's always a question of budget and other requests, performance, and so on. But I think this is just in general what I would use when I had to decide what to use for a new project. Yeah, so that's for me. All charts will be available later on this link, and also on the Xamarin Expert Day GitHub page. Together with the slides. Thanks so much for coming.